I'm at least set back reporting.
Get ready to fight, and she's really coming along. I gotta get this girl a little stronger.
Yeah, for sure.
Boys, give us your game face, your mean face, your eye of the tiger.
Oh gosh, I can't do that. Not on the spot.
This is pretty scary, huh?
You come from an MMA background before you got into boxing.
Jiu-jitsu.
Yes. Okay, yeah. What's the difference between that and boxing?
Oh, there's a lot.
Like I mean, what's tougher physically?
They're so different. You can't really compare them. They, you know, if you, even as shape as I am for jiu-jitsu, it still doesn't translate to boxing because it's a different cardio, it's different strength. Definitely the athleticism helps and like the patience. But other than that, it is way different.
Okay, Brennan. As Brennan Krause, how do you rate Conor McGregor's boxing? And he listed to me the mistakes that McGregor makes. Not tucking the chin down. What else did you say, Brennan?
He doesn't have a good guard. He's off balance a lot of times. Yeah, he
overextends.
Well, he's like late, like throws like showy like looping shots that you're just not gonna get away with a world class boxer.
Now that said. From your experience, how difficult is it to get in there and inspire people who just box all their life?
Oh, it's harder. It's a different stance. It's a different strategy. Even though, I guess it's hard to explain just because you think just because it's boxing, that because you have so like much more experience in different martial arts that, you know, you're going to be okay in the ring.
Okay.
But that's not the case.
In boxing, Brandon, 3 minutes seemed like 30 minutes when you spar. 2 minutes. In MMA, do you gas out the same way? Do you gas out
for
fast?
Sure. For sure.
Same, so that's the same?
Yeah, but it's a different cardio, too, because then you have to, like, going on the ground is a lot of cardio, and it's different. So, I mean, my cardio on the ground, it's good for rolling, but for competition, no. But same thing with sparring. Like, I can spar, but as far as a competition, it's just, I'll have to do more. It's different. You just really, it's all, like, ring time. It's all mat time. So really, the only way to get used to that is by doing it.
Conor McGregor has 2 or 3 months to get ready for Floyd. Amanda just told me the cardiovascular that you exert in MMA is different than boxing.
It is.
Here it's short, explosive. Over there, maybe it's more patient. I'm not sure. How do you compare them?
I think there's more anaerobic involved in boxing than MMA, especially the times when MMA turns into rolling or ground and pound. I think it's going to be a completely different energy set. Now listen. Conor is a skilled guy on his feet, and if Conor decided he wanted to, you know, turn pro and invest in a boxing career, he would get better. You know, in 25, 30 fights, I bet you the guy would be pretty good.
That would be
good.
5 years, 4 years.
But to think that this guy—I mean, it's laughable. Anybody with any common sense knows that. And look, props to Conor. Like the guys. For his pro debut, he's getting paid $70 million, right?
Hey, that's he won amazing. Already. He's already.
I had
already.
To pay $25,000 to get this. $2,500 to get this guy's paper debut.
Pro.
So, and he seems like a guy that if he really wanted to start a boxing career, I bet you, in 5-8 years, okay. He would have a successful.
He gets just
prospect / contender, maybe.
Well, he has the personality to make himself a star. That's important.
Yep.
He loses to Floyd bad. Maybe gets knocked out. Maybe gets stopped. Maybe just gets outclassed. Does that crush his boxing dream, or does he say, you know what, I want to prove everybody that I could do this. I'm going to start again.
That's going to be... He is supposed to lose to Floyd terribly. He's in a win-win situation, you know? If Conor goes out there and lands a couple good shots, like, we'll all be giving him props, you know what I mean?
If he lands one shot.
Yeah.
Well, Ricky Haddon, quote, said... Oscar De La Hoya couldn't touch him. I couldn't touch him. Canelo couldn't touch him. All these legends that he fought, why would Conor McGregor even think he could touch him?
Conor doesn't believe it. Conor doesn't believe it. And this power that like a guy like Skip Bayless keeps fucking talking about. Bro, Floyd took Manny's best left hand. Zab Judah's
Maidana,
best left hands.
Mosley, who people are telling
me. You know what I mean? It's Conor doesn't hit harder than those guys. I'm sorry, he doesn't.
And even if he does, because I've seen... Powerlifters box, they gas out, Brennan. It doesn't matter. Power doesn't always mean you're
well,
gonna win.
Well, he gassed out in both of his fights with Diaz. That was like a
and he
somewhat.
Was, well, he was running so
it
much.
Was like
he was
a somewhat
doing,
fast-paced
he was doing the LA
fight.
Marathon in the octagon.
And that's what I just, you know, building yourself up to the stamina of a championship fight is a lifetime in the making. No shit. It's not a fucking 8-week training camp.
But I will say the lead into this fight will be crazy. Will be hilarious. I can't wait for the press conference. I think they're both gonna talk mad shit.
Yeah, sure.
And we'll talk about it. We'll say, did you hear what Conor said? Did you hear what Floyd said?
And there hasn't been a person that really talked shit to Floyd in a long time. Just Hatton 10 years ago. Pacquiao didn't talk shit. Cotto respected him a lot. Ortiz was too timid. Mosley tried to talk a little shit, you know, but like Conor's gonna be real blank with his, so that's gonna be a real, real entertaining build-up.
I don't know, but you know, here's the thing. And when Conor is in the MMA build-ups, like, he thinks he's gonna win. I don't. This is gonna be different. Like, Conor knows he's not gonna win. So
well, he
I wonder,
is gonna win because he's getting $70 million.
All right. So yeah, it's a win in that sense. But the bravado he brings to the UFC is because he knows he's gonna go up there and thump somebody's head. This shit ain't gonna happen this time. And he's gonna have a 6-week press tour with Floyd. With Floyd being taking the Conor position. With Floyd knowing, bro,
he's the A side.
Yeah.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. FuseReport.com, Basic Back Reporting.
Yeah. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FuseReport.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EllieSecback. Take a step back. Take a step back.